Yo, anybody hear me? All right. Everybody. You hear me okay? You see me okay? What are we even doing here? I'm super fired up. I'm gonna try to, hey, what's up, Lexi? I'm gonna try to keep an eye on the chat, you know, but I also want to stay on task because we have a lot to do today. You know, this isn't just like I'm gonna have a sardine or 12. This is gonna be like a real problem, right? Okay. So nervous. Thanks everybody for coming. I feel like I'm playing. I mean, to me, this is like the Madison Square Garden of canned fish. You know. Pumped. Got some boxes here. This is Slow Jabroni's box. Okay, sure. But I thought we'd open the show with a little bit of Rainbow Tomato Gardens. You know, Rainbow Tomatoes Gardens. I don't know. And I just show off, kind of like what I got from Dan. Come on, knife. What are you guys doing? I see a lot of familiar faces. Drew Who says, do I have a bucket? No, I don't have a bucket. No, I've got a wastebasket right here if things go super sideways, right? Okay. Let's go full screen. This is what happens when you order stuff from Dan. You know? Okay, you open this up. Oh man, here's the checklist, right? All the fish we're gonna conquer. And then, what do we got? Stickers. I got a coaster. This is a coaster. And then, look at this. Oh, this is from the subreddit. You guys have seen all this stuff before, right? Yeah. There are commercials and stuff. Okay. Yeah, this stuff is super nicely packaged. And there's peanuts, which nobody likes peanuts, but kind of a what do you call it? How do you say not a fact of life, but I don't know. We just have to deal with them. What is this? El Capricho Santona Asturian. I don't even remember ordering this. Sturgeon. Oh, I got sturgeon. Okay. Yeah, I guess Asturian is Spanish for sturgeon, right? So that'll be exciting. What do we got? Oh, okay. This is hake cheeks. Hake cheeks? I don't know. Yeah, but this was a fancy one. This was expensive. This and the sturgeon. This stuff was pricey. So I don't know. I don't know when it's going to be such a special occasion that we're going to be eating that stuff. But Lexi, I can dissolve these in water. Okay. All right. I'll try it. No, these are just regular old. No, they're not regular old. These are sardines and sauce from Ramon Peñas. I don't know. What kind are these? Okay, so this has got, you know, onion, tomato, pepper, wine, and some spices. Okay, whatever, cool. No, Slow Jabroni didn't send me this stuff. I'm going to open up his box, but I thought, you know, I'd, you know, let the crowd file in while I open up the RTG order. This is what made me make this order, because Dan was like, yo, we have the Gua et Nature sardines with lobster oil. So I was like, yeah, I need it now. So I ordered the rest of this stuff just to fill out the order, really, you know. But this is what I'm super pumped about because I love sardines. I love lobster. And if you want to read the newspaper from wherever Dan's at, this is from somewhere in Pennsylvania. Look at this, local news. Man exposed himself, police say. How do you like that? We got more lobster. Who's this lady? Okay, this is probably something that's a bummer. I don't want to bum anybody out. Oh, Angelo Pirati. So these are Portuguese sardines. I guess these are probably, what do we got? It's pilchards. And I just haven't had them. People ask me about them. And I don't want to go around being like the last dude to ever try them. So I'm going to try them. Yeah, when I say Dan, I mean Dan from RainbowTomatoesGarden.com, you know, or however the URL is. Pennsylvania is where Dracula lives? Yeah, I think so. Pennsylvania, oh yeah, yeah. You guys don't remember the Pennsylvania 65,000. Boy, how many Pirates did I get? I must have gotten, okay, so we've got olive oil ones and we've got picante ones. So I got two of each. So one will be my stunt can and one will be the one that I eat. Hillary and Matt look satisfied with their tin fish today. Yeah, Hillary is so excited. I can't get her to shut up. She just won't stop. Yeah, so this is another make that I wasn't like familiar with, but these are sardinillas. These are little sardines, little pilchards, I guess. And product of Spain. What's the cannery called? Like they're so hipster, they don't even put the name of the cannery on here. And I can't. Maria Organic. Which is kind of funny to call your company, like your sardine cannery, like organic. Like, I don't know. Like, you don't know what these sardines do on their own time. They could be eating like all kinds of like McDonald's or something. And okay. Dan has little chopsticks made up. That's nice. That's nice. And then the chopsticks even have a little obi on them that says, right, you see this? Rainbow Tomatoes Garden? Yeah, that's nice. I'm gonna use these today. Eleanor asks, hey, I've always wondered what you do when you're not eating canned fish. I do all the same stuff anybody else would do, you know? I get up, I take a shower. I work. Mostly I just work. And then I try to play as much pinball as I possibly can. Okay, so yeah, RTG haul, always fun. It seemed like such a big haul, but actually just looking at the stack of cans over here, it wasn't that much. So that I'm grateful because I got like, you see over there, we've got just you can partially see the wall of sardines. There's King Oscars, I got a bunch of Polistrinis, Patagonias, some Randos, and then there's a whole area where I kind of have them semi-organized. Okay, so what we're dealing with here is allow me to play an exhibit for you guys. This fool, what's he called? Yeah, Slow Jabroni. We did a collaboration. This is backstory, right? Like, I mean, you don't need to know this, but I feel like you should know. Oh, look at this guy. Oh my God. Yeah. So I sent him a box of my best sardines that I didn't feel like eating. And he ate them and he liked them, but then they kind of made him feel, you know, kind of ill, I guess, you know? Let's see what happens here. I can skip around in the video. Oh yeah, he ate them. So, and the next morning, this is great, dude. This is, Academy Award goes to this guy. Yeah. So the deans knocked him out, whatever I sent him, they weren't good. Okay. And he's like, two can play at that game. Yeah, right. So he sent me, well, what is that? What, Scout? Something, 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 something? It better not be Surstroming, you know? Or however you say it. What's the chat saying? My wife, Melissa, is a secret freaky fish freak, but is mainly watching for olive oil sipping action. Yeah. Well, I know what the lady's like. Anyway, what do we got? So, Slo sent me this box, and it's very cute. He drew a picture of, is this me? Yeah, I guess it's me. Oh, that's my old hair. And then, prepare to Dean. Yeah, you know, what does the guy say in James Bond? Like, I don't expect you to talk. I expect you to Dean. You guys, this is only the third stream that I've done, and you know how weird it is. Maybe you do know. It just feels like I'm talking to myself. Like I'm trying to interact with you guys as much as I can. I kind of wish that you guys were just 10 feet in front of me, and you know, I could hear you yelling, you know, yelling weird stuff. What do we got? Squealy D, it's time for the revenge of Slo Jabroni. Yeah, you could say that. He wrote me a note here. Hey Matt, thanks so much for the Deans. They rocked. I definitely did not have heartburn all night. Please see enclosed bangers. Hope you enjoy. That's my best Slo Jabroni impression. You're welcome. Okay, so I feel like I'm gonna open these up and I'm gonna see them all at once. This one's scary because it's, herring fillets in aspic. Oh no, I remember this episode. If you guys don't know, you gotta check out Slo's YouTube channel. I'm gonna keep calling him by his code name because, you know, he does important work for the government. I don't wanna expose him. Dude, okay, first of all, this freaking can is sticky. And it's not, like, it's sticky, tacky, and greasy. And the picture on here is gross. It's gross. I mean, I don't want to put down the Rugenkron people or wherever they're from. Where are they from? It doesn't matter. But they've just like, okay, we've got a slice of hard-boiled egg and some dill and some carrots. Like, everything in the world that doesn't go together, they've put on their little picture here. This may be the final act. All right. We may start out with some easy stuff, right? Like scout. How bad could it be? This scout, wild white albacore toonie. That's gonna be easy. Rudder Frank, thanks for the super chat, bro. I'm gonna spend that cash on sardines. Okay. What do we got? So scout. This is the least scary stuff you could possibly throw in. So this is just some good protein. God damn, that's a tough. Excuse me, that's a tough can. All right. Plates. Yeah, we're gonna go titanium. Now this looks pretty good, man. I mean, it kind of does look like a big piece of chicken breast. It's kind of chewy too. I mean, this is good, man. This is really good. I mean, it's just tuna. I just shot a tuna episode recently. I gotta edit it tomorrow or something. And it's Ortiz. So I did regular tuna, and then it's just like in a can like this. And then I tried the Ventresca as well. Slow says, enjoy your chicken puck, Maddie boy. Yeah, this is like crazy how similar to chicken breast this is. It's not as thready as chicken breast, but oh no. I have the hiccups. Is that supposed to work? Ugh. The sexual tension between you and canned fish is palpable. H, my number one guy, man. What do we got? Conservas Santos, sardinas. M, limão. Sardines and lemon sauce. This is from Portugal. I got a horn honking convention outside. This is a cannery that I'm not familiar with. And they've got this very like, you know, soap my wife buys kind of packaging here that should make me like it, right? Because I love paper packaging. And I don't know. This looks classy, right? And I'll judge a book by its cover. That looks sanitary. Okay, let's just open it up. Yeah. Okay. So these just look like, they look like pilchards. Oh, I thought I said I was gonna use Dan's new chopsticks, yeah. These are good for freebies. These are good. I think you can wash these and use these over and over again. I wanna sell my own chopsticks at some point. I wanna like figure out what are good ones, and then have like some stuff printed on them, and then like I don't know, sell them so I can quit my day job one day. But these are good, man. These are, yeah, for some free chopsticks that I pulled out of a box. Okay, let's concentrate. Kind of delicate skin, but that doesn't mean anything. I see some scales, but like, I don't know. Like, fish have scales and they're not just like falling off. I don't know. What do you think? Get ready to spit scales out all week, Matty boy. Yeah, they are kind of scaly, and also they're a little bit on the mushy, but not necessarily super fall aparty side. But they're not like, they're not bad. They're not weird. Yeah, they just kind of mush up on you. I don't know. Yeah. I wouldn't be stoked if I got like a dozen of these that I had to work through. Let's take a look on the inside, huh? What do we got? Come apart. Got a decent spine. Yeah, for what it's worth. Slow says, they aren't terrible, but every avenue you look at is pretty lacking on these guys. Yeah. It's like they weren't super pretty. The lemon and the olive oil isn't knocking me out. The texture's not knocking me out. There's just like ham. I got some protein. I feel good. My skin's gonna love it. Time for what I'm thinking of as the main event. I'm gonna go back to titanium because I feel like I gotta be ready for anything, right? The sweet says there is always Espinoler to help bad deans out. Oh, Drew says, wait, drink the oil. Yeah, you got it. You got it. You got it, buddy. Yeah. Okay. Wait a minute. I'm gonna go. Like, just in case, this is just too much to deal with. We've got a backup plan, huh? All right, Melissa, you happy? Okay, herring fillets in aspic. Rügenkron. So this isn't Rügen fish because I like, right? That's a brand name. Yeah, we're not gonna do the spoon. I might just have to drench these guys. Clupea horrendous. Aspic. They just say, yeah, one of the ingredients is aspic. Like that helps me at all. Oh my God. Oh man. Edward, thanks for the super chat, buddy. Oh. So it's like what shot out of the can was a lot more like loose than I thought it was gonna be. I don't smell anything. Are you supposed to smell something? Chris asked if I'm a bike messenger. No, but I like riding bikes a lot. I do. Okay. All right. This is like somebody made me weird cold fish soup. I feel like I forget how Slow did it on his video, but I'm gonna take a carrot, and I have this weird feeling like he started out with a carrot too. It's so weird. I can't. It's like I'm not getting anything from this aspic. I don't know. It's kind of. What? This taste is like it's like an inside out taste. I don't know what that means to anybody. Uber Austin says this is like what your least favorite aunt brings to a family get together. Yeah, you're 100%. I don't have any least favorite aunts, but I totally get the vibe you're talking about. It's sour. It's so there's Flyclop says, isn't aspic supposed to be solid? Yeah, that's what I would have thought because I don't know. It should be kind of gelatinous, right? And I don't know if there's some kind of Slow says the aspic is supposed to be a jelly man. What the heck? Now you're scaring me. Like, this isn't even like what it's supposed to be like. Was it kind of sour tasting? Was it kind of it sort of tastes like it's fermented or something. Oh my goodness. I should have talked to my lawyer before this. It probably melted. Okay. All right. Even Jell-O. Okay, everybody's cooling me off here. I don't know. This isn't like, yeah, it's like they got it's like a bad flavor. It's like they decided to make it a bad flavor. I don't know. I don't want to put down whoever's like, "Oh yeah, this stuff is so good. This is how we've made it for centuries." But I don't know. Espinal our time. Dude, it wants the Espinal. I never seen a fish hold on to the Espinal so well. And now it tastes good. All right. Po folks at Espinal, you guys know where to send the check. I'm trying to sell your stuff as good as I can. I think you need the hot Espinal for this, though. I mean, this is the hot. Is there a hair? That better have been my hair. Oh my goodness. There's so much. I don't even know what the point is with the carrots. I feel like the carrots are just like whatever, we put them in there. I mean, it's one thing to throw like a pepper or a slice of cucumber or something. But the deal with the carrots is like they're all chopped up. I don't know. I don't get it. So nobody made any terms. He says it's not fair that I'm using the Espinard sauce, but this is my house. I can do whatever I want. So good. Now it's good. The taste of Espinoler with the texture of fish. It's Rügenkrön with Espinoler. All right. Now, Prescott says the carrots are there just to keep you grounded. Okay. I'm just gonna sip this just to just because if I don't, then everybody'll be like, Matt's a totally a lamer. He didn't drink the aspic. It's not like viscerally revolting. If somebody upsold it to me and they were like, "Oh yeah, this is great stuff. It's this great broth," and I tasted it, I'd be like, "Yeah, I guess it's fine. It doesn't really taste like anything." But just this ugly can, and the weird like sort of half pickled herring, makes the aspic like not appetizing. And like, if anybody was gonna think it was appetizing, like, you know. It'd be me, right? Slow says, "Yeah, that's the face I wanted to see." Yeah, are you happy, buddy? All right. I feel like I'm out of cans here. Oh, wait a minute. There's another thing here. Oh, wow. Okay. There's another can in the box. Slow says truce. What could this be? Hillary, you want a closer look? There you go, baby. Just a can or maybe it's a flask. Oh, okay. It's a cool little It's a cool little gift bag that he made for me. Oh, these are his what do you call them? A bumper stickers that he's made. How is my driving? Do you have any sardines? Will you share them with me if I pull over? That's nice, dude. I'm gonna put that on my my thing where I put all my stickers, right? Because I don't have a car, but if I did, it would go on my car. Oh, and then he's got some mackerel pate. Yeah, sure. Never tried it, so I'm into it. Oh my God, dude, this is so nice, man. And I totally sent him a box of crap, and now he sends me this nice stuff. Okay, look. My dude's making up these pins. I don't know where are we at on these pins, man? Are you selling them yet? 'Cause these are gonna be a big deal, dude. I don't know how much you're gonna ask for them or whatever, but look, it's chopsticks eating some tin fish. I mean, come on. Come on. Let's get real. And then I got some Star Trek pins he sent me. Dude, these are just like my actual two cats, Gorgar and Paco. This looks like Gorgar is a orange cat and Paco is a tuxedo cat with a little cap like that. Dude, that's so sweet, man. That's so sweet. Thank you. Okay. What's happening, guys? Are you still with me? Who do we got? I got Franklin Lee. Franklin, you don't even eat sardines yet? You gotta get on it. Just go down to Walmart and get some MW Polars or just anything, you know? They won't hurt. Yeah, I gotta say, you know, Slow Jabroni, my best sardine friend, you know? Yeah. You know, I tried to make other sardine friends around the house, you know, in the neighborhood, and nobody wants to do it, you know? Drew, who wants to know, are they still making sardine tins the old way with the key? Yeah, I don't know. I haven't seen them. But you know what's weird? I was looking for some some graphics to put on a video of like a tin can or whatever. And when you just Google image search, what do we got? Sardine tin can. The pictures that you get are old style with the key. So like obviously that is still in the minds of people that you know when they you know that's how they envision sardines. All right. Yeah, I'm gonna have trouble with there. Ignatz from Hungary. He says hi from Hungary. They say hi from Hungary. Bradley, my cat does not eat deans. I mean, I don't really try to make them, you know? And they don't seem to come around when I'm doing it. I think when I'm eating the sardines, I'm acting so spastic and dominant that they don't want to, you know, they don't want the smoke, you know? Don asks, have I ever met Slow Jabroni? I've never met him. We're gonna get together sometime, but you know, we're always busy. He's busy, I'm busy. We got pandemic on, you know. There's just a lot of stuff stopping all the stuff. I wanted to do sort of a Pennsylvania road trip. I wanted to go down to Rainbow Tomatoes Garden this summer and check it out when all the tomatoes are happening. But you know, I don't know. It just didn't happen. I still want to go down there, you know. I want to do more like outside stuff. Here's something. Mouthful of Sardines. You guys know him? You should check out his YouTube channel because he's got a lot of like nice short videos to watch. He does this thing where he takes cans of sardines and he puts them in those like little pantries that you see around, you know, like those little libraries. And he sent me his little kit for doing that. And so I'm gonna do a video where I go around and try that stuff too. I'm gonna put sardines away so people can find them and eat them, and I can spread the sardine word. All right, what else we got? Hey, Darker Than Dark, what's up? Fresh versus canned video? Yeah, maybe. I'm just so not into. Look, my neck is blushing because I'm excited. I don't cook much, really, and I don't really do many recipes with sardines. And also, in this apartment, my kitchen is so small and it's so hard to cook in and shoot in that that's the main reason why I haven't done it. And when we move, me and my wife probably gonna move in like 5 or 6 months or something. Hopefully the kitchen will accommodate a little bit more shooting. Yeah. Bindu says he's gonna go out and get some nurries. Yeah. Oh man. Okay. Well, I don't know. I feel like we've done what we're gonna do. I've had such a good time. This was like I was so nervous to get started, and then once I got going, it's just like it's as easy as breathing. Duke of Sardines, hey brother, thank you so much for the super chat, man. He says he's eating sardines on my boat in Miami. Love from Florida. Yeah. All right, guys, thanks so much, man. I can't believe, like, it says it's 103 people watching right now, and that's, to me, that is just unbelievable, that anybody would notice or care, and that we could get it to this point, because I remember, like, playing in bands and stuff, and like, oh, we would just kill to have 20 people come and watch us, so it makes me so grateful to be here and get to interact with you guys, Okay? All right. Bye. No, you hang up. No, you hang up. Okay. Thanks a lot, guy. What how do I sign off on videos? What do I say? Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Yeah, that's what we do. Peace.